The manager and leader of Joy of Business, and I have been hijacking people today in South Africa because we just started up this conversation about these classes that we're creating with Joy of Business, and we just started talking about, oh, and this changed for me, and that changed for me, and this has been awesome, and they've just turned into these amazing stories that I really wanted to share with you. And surprisingly, I literally don't know what these stories are until we hit record, so they're all a surprise to me too. And today I have with me here Helle, who I have met through some of the most massive classes in Access Consciousness that she has been a part of. And now we've luckily, and I'm so grateful, like nabbed her into Joy of Business for a class in Copenhagen happening in June. And I'm just so grateful for this sweet, kind woman that creates like, I can't even describe. And I don't know yet what her point of view in business is, but I'm gonna ask her right now. Like, what has Joy of Business, how has that come into your life?
Wow. I took my first class, I think, with the Joy of Business about 1.5 years ago.
Uh-huh.
And it literally changed my whole universe because for me, you know, I was a psychotherapist and I had my own company for 16 years. And for me, the word business was, uh-oh, it's a corporate world, and no, I'm just having my own little company, you know. But what really changed for me in that class was that Simone built a bridge between this corporate world and me. And it's changed so much for me, it's wow. And because I'm coming for this world, it has to be a hard work, you know, to have your own company and all the financial stuff and all that. And but it creates so much more ease for me, and it's just, yeah.
So business can be easy.
It's so easy.
That's crazy.
Yeah, because I don't have to do the financial stuff. I can just, you know, find a person who can do it for me.
Right.
If I don't think that's easy and fun for me.
Yeah, so let's talk about that. So, I mean, in business, all especially for like entrepreneurs or small businesses, you have a point of view that you have to do it all.
Yeah.
You're the one-man show or the one-woman show. So how is it okay to hire people to do things, or how is, like, it's a luxury to hire people to do the things you don't like doing?
Yes, and actually I have been asking this question from other, you know, my colleague, and I said, you know, if I can hire a person to do that, I can earn money, you know, doing my business, you know, with clients and do classes, so I don't have to do that. So it's, yeah.
Huh. So the more you hire out, the things that you're not necessarily good at or want to do, the more time you can have for that whole money follows joy thing.
Yes.
I don't know if you guys have heard this before, but Dr. Dang here, a great friend of Simone's, says money follows joy. Joy does not follow money. Mm-hmm. And so when you start to create your business with more of the joy and doing the things that bring you that joy, the money seems to show up.
Yes.
And it did. It did.
A lot.
Oh, it did. Yes. It works. It works.
It works. Yeah.
Cool. So, what are some of the tools that you love and adore from Joy of Business that you would like other people to know?
Yeah, you know, because before I was always thinking, what can I do? But now I step into the space of what can I be with my business, you know, because I found out by Simone, you know, my business is my life. So what can I be today to create beyond what I ever thought was possible? So
what can I do or be today to create beyond what I knew was possible? What a cool question. Awesome. Well, thank you, Helle.
Thank you.
It's always just a pleasure to be around you. And as I said before, I'm so grateful she's one of our Joy of Business hosts. And if you would like to meet this incredible lady, she's going to be in Copenhagen. And we're doing some classes all over the world. You can see them at accessjoybusiness.com.